It's Rockwiz! Would you please pump it up for the musical muscle of the Rockwiz Orchestra? On drums, Peter Perfect Pecs Luscombe. On the bass guitar, Mark Sixpack Ferry. And strutting his stuff on Hammond and Telecaster, James Bulging Bicep Black. To incorrectly quote Dusty Springfield, the only boy who could ever reach her was the son of a pizza man, super and supreme, your host, Julia Demero!
Good evening and welcome to Rockwiz, where our motto is Sitius Sonitus Reverbus, which of course is Latin for faster, louder, and hey, how about a little bit of reverb? As usual, we are guided on this long and winding road by a man who has made the name Brian Nankervis his very own. Brian Nankervis!
Thank you, Julia. Thank you, and well done. We'd like to say well done to American biologist Jason Bond, who recently named a new species of spider after Neil Young. The species is unique in that after mating, the female kills the male, eats him, and then sings like a hurricane in a quavering, strangled voice.
Earlier tonight, we cast our net into the Rockwiz live audience, hoping to snare a quartet of rock brainiacs to compete in tonight's show. Here they are, the catch of the day! Good evening, Ian.
Evening.
Evening, how are you?
I'm exceptionally well.
Now, Ian, would you like to share with us the first concert you ever went to?
It was 1968.
Ooh.
Surf Beach Lawn, Wild Colonial Club, The Loved Ones.
Oh, The Loved Ones, gee.
Gerry Humphries.
Did you have that moustache in 1968?
No.
You didn't, pity. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mark.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Mark, you've only got 20% vision, I understand. Yes,
sure
I'm very beautiful. Just so you know, in case you're wondering, you can touch me any time tonight that you feel like it. Now, Mark, what was the first album you ever bought?
Oh, do I have to say?
Yes, I'm afraid you do, sadly.
ABBA's Super Trooper.
Thank you for sharing that with us, Mark. I appreciate it. Please welcome Steve as well. Hello, Steve. Share with us the first concert you ever went to, Steve.
Believe it or not, it was actually Cold Joy.
Cold Joy, who's just celebrated 50 years in the Australian rock industry.
Yeah, I don't think it was in his first couple of years that I saw him. I was thinking it was probably about mid-60s, 65, in the Picture Theatre in Kempsey.
Oh, that's gorgeous. Now, Libby, can I please have the first concert you ever went to?
1987.
Yeah.
Boondall, sunny Brisbane. Sunny. Young Talent Time.
Young Talent Time. Mark, your Super Trooper's looking decidedly cool after that. Young Talent Time, was Danny there?
Danny was there in all her glory.
Really? Mm. Without all the injection work?
No, she looked relatively like a 15-year-old.
Like a 15-year-old? Oh, happy times. Of course, tonight's teams are a bit hollow shells without the two special musical guests standing by, ready to cross the threshold. Let's part the curtain of mystery, shall we? Who can it be now? I was born in Newcastle in 1984. My father's record collection introduced me to country artists like Loretta Lynn, Hank Williams and Dolly Parton and inspired me to begin performing and writing my own songs. Early in my career, I collaborated with Bill Chambers and Casey Chambers, but the real surprise was when Elton John bought my album and said he just loved my voice. Yes, Ian?
Catherine Britt.
Please make her very welcome, Catherine Britt!
Thank you. oyster and it's full of pearls. So honey, tell me who's the lucky girl. Lucky boy, did you tell her she's your second choice? 'Cause I wouldn't be your little toy.
Thank you. Thanks for having me here.
Oh, glad. Now, look, here's an interesting little point. Now, firstly, I just have to say that nowadays, Catherine moves between the two ends, Nashville and Newcastle. Newcastle up north. So you live in Nashville now?
I do. I kind of, you know, go between the two a fair bit, 6 months here, 6 months there sort of thing. But I've been home for a while. I'm loving it just a little bit too much.
Now, I'm just wondering, you've got Elton John walking into a record shop going, that looks quite good, Herb Lewson. That girl, give her a call. Talk about it for 2 weeks, find a number. Does she have a manager? Let me do a bit of work. How weird is that?
It's pretty weird, yeah.
So
I mean,
did you get the call from him personally?
Not the first time, no, it was kind of like a, you know, his people, my people sort of thing.
Yes, yes, I get that all the time, yes.
Yes, yes. But no, he got in contact with me to come see him play, actually. He wanted me to come and see him play in Sydney, so I went down and met him backstage, and he was just lovely, you know, he was a big fan. I was like, really?
That
Are
is
you sure?
And then you recorded a song together.
Yeah, we recorded a duet that was released in America on country radio. So
I'm sure we can Google that or iTunes it or something with the intraminet that I don't know how to use at all. Well, it's interesting because when Catherine came here tonight, because she's not often in the country of Australia visiting, we got her on the show. Of course, she brought family with her, as you would. They want to come and see her perform. And in our pre-selection, of course, before the show, her father was pretty keen to get up here and see if he could, well, cut the mustard. Steve, what relation are you to Catherine Britt?
I've never seen her before in my life. What? No, she's my daughter.
She is your daughter, ladies and gentlemen.
I can't believe that you're on the other team. I'm so going to lose.
Oh, you don't know who you've got next to you. I think you'll find...
Oh, no, not that I'm talking you guys down at all, but just my dad's a... encyclopedia.
Well, let's see if that actually works out tonight. Welcome, Catherine. Thank you.
Thank you.
Very excited to have you on board. Now, no hints, Catherine, because you've been out the back with our other guests swapping fruity anecdotes about Dougal. So, who can it be, Maintenant? I formed my first band at the age of 15 to play in youth clubs around Christchurch, New Zealand. Now, look, you'd really be a bit embarrassed if you got it wrong.
Christchurch, New Zealand. I was at the ARIA Hall of Fame, and it's got to be Max Merritt. Christchurch, 15.
Please, make him very welcome, Max Merritt!
Hey, Western Union man, send a telegram to my baby. Send a telegram, send a telegram.
send it on to my baby. Gonna make it all right. Listen, tell her that I'm all alone. Try to call her on the phone. Tell her I'm in misery. Think that she's a void of me. If a telegram won't do, send a box of candy too. Maybe some flowers. Tell her that I'm missing for hours and hours. Send a telegram, send a telegram. Send it on to my baby. Gonna make it all right. Western Union man, send a telegram, send a telegram to my baby. Western Union man, send a telegram, send a telegram, send a telegram, send it on to my baby. Gonna make it all right. Listen, tell her that I'm all alone. Follow her on the phone. Have you got a boy can sing? Send him out right away. Maybe tomorrow. Maybe right away. I want a girl to know that I miss her. Something like yesterday. Send a telegram, send a telegram. Send it on to my baby. Gonna make it all right. Western Union man. Send a telegram, send a telegram to my baby. Western Union man, send a telegram, send a telegram, send a telegram. Send it on to my baby, gonna make it all right. All right, bud.
I'm pretty good.
Yeah, look.
I'm pretty good. Remarkable for a man of my vintage.
Remarkable indeed. Now, of course, you were inducted, you freak, into the ARIA Hall of Fame. I mean, he guessed you in a sentence and a half, Christchurch, New Zealand, apparently gave her away. How was that? How did you go at the ARIA Hall of Fame that night?
How did I go?
Mm.
You were there.
I know I was there, but they weren't. So I'm just saying, maybe could you... Was it a good night?
It was remarkable. It was great.
Yeah.
Wonderful, a very moving, very emotional evening for everybody.
Yeah. You supported the Stones, the Rolling Ones, at one point. What in the world was that tour like?
It was great. It was exciting. You know, we were kids. We were young, let's put it that way. And to be in the midst of all that confusion and the delirium, you know, was fabulous.
Now, Mr. Merritt, could you share with us the first concert you ever went to? I'm very keen to hear.
It was the Platters, Tommy Sand, and Johnny O'Keefe.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Max Merritt, welcome to Rockquiz. We are absolutely delighted to have you on the show, and with Catherine as well. It's a beautiful combo. All right, the pleasantries, as always, have been pleasant. But for the uninitiated, this is the way the show starts. Not with a whimper, but with a bang. Oh, as T.S. Eliot said, here we go round the prickly pear at 5 o'clock in the morning. What he really meant was, hands on buzzers. Let's play. Who sang Ma Belle? Sont des mots qui vont très bien ensemble.
The Beatles?
The Beatles is correct, absolutely. What about a translation for Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir? Yes, oh, yes, Steve.
Will you sleep with me tonight?
Well, no, I can't sleep with you tonight because it's utterly inappropriate, but that's absolutely correct right there. Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir? Lady Marmalade, of course, nothing about a couch, coucher, or furniture. It's about sex, as usual. And who sang that song?
La Belle.
La Belle is correct. Name one of Janis Joplin's backing bands. Yes, Ian.
Full Tilt Boogie Band. Full Tilt. Well, the Full Tilt Boogie Band.
Right, that's absolutely correct, Ian. I'm glad you said it twice. That's good.
I'm trying to think of the first one.
Here is the single. Name the album that it originally appeared on. Son of a Preacher Man, Dusty Springfield. Yes, Ian.
It's not Dusty in Memphis.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, it is.
It is Dusty in Memphis.
Correct! The single is Walk on the Wild Side, Lou Reed. What album is it off? Yes, Mark.
Transformer.
That's correct, absolutely. Never Tear Us Apart by INXS. Yes.
Kick.
Kick is absolutely correct. Very good. The Eurythmics, Would I Lie to You? Yes.
Be Yourself Tonight.
Oh, absolutely correct. Well done. Can you give me a year, Mark?
Yeah, came out in the middle of 1985.
Oh, hello. Absolutely correct. Very good. Cheap Wine, Cold Chisel. Yes.
Not East, it's the...
No, it is.
Yes, it's East.
It is East. I said it.
Ian, you must believe in yourself. Maybe that involves shaving off that moustache. I don't know.
Who famously duetted with these singers? Tammy Wynette. Yes.
George Jones.
George Jones, I will accept. I would have accepted KLF as well. It's a bit hard on the ears. Sorry about that. Graham Parsons. Yes.
Emmylou Harris.
Oh, you're on the ball there, Steve. Correct. Now, complete this lyric, singing, if possible, and name the song and artist. She's got a smile that it seems to me
reminds me of childhood memories where everything was as fresh as a bright blue sky.
Who sings that, Catherine?
Guns N' Roses.
What's the name of the song?
Sweet Child of Mine.
15 points. Complete this lyric. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone.
Ain't no love when she's away.
That's absolutely right.
Ain't no sunshine since she's gone. She's always gone too long. Anytime she goes away.
I could fall in love with you, Max Merritt.
Please do.
Please do. What's the name of the song?
Ain't No Sunshine Since She's Gone.
Who sang it?
Bill Withers.
Would you like 15 points? 15 points right now! Oh. Complete this lyric. Oh, she may be weary.
Young girls do get weary.
Wearing that same... I can't sing it, Max, but I adore that
commit,
song.
Commit, commit,
well, when she gets weary, try a little tenderness.
Are you trying to crack on again? Title of the song?
Hmm?
Title of
try
the song?
Try a little tenderness.
Who sang
Otis
it?
Redding.
Of course he did. 15 points right there.
His interpretation was as good, if not better, than Otis's.
Oh, round of applause. I think we'd all agree to that.
Open spaces to colourful cities. Together, we are one country. SBS and NITV connect you with our rich Indigenous culture through fascinating, entertaining and informative stories.
The Southern Cross is an emu footprint.
When you lift his feet up, you put his footprints there, you become a Southern Cross.
I'd like to go to the ceremony because I want to be a man.
I believe the Yes I Can is the answer to my community.
Let SBS and NITV take you on a journey. Walk with us.
For anyone who has ever felt invisible, for anyone...
That tree's amazing. That's our friend.
whoever needed to find hope.
I can help you.
Comes a visually spectacular emotional journey. Critics rave. It's an unforgettable masterpiece.
You will like a thrill.
That will make your spirit soar.
For this is why you called me. Come on.
A Monster Calls.
Welcome back, chefs. Here you are. Each week, there will be two challenges.
Boom!
I want it.
That's you.
The winner survives, the loser leaves.
This is like straight up war.
The worst is yet to come. Jeff, you're scaring me.
You have to beat three Iron Chefs.
You've got the consistency on the custard just right.
I like it. Thank you, Chef.
If you happen to succeed in this quest,
how much time?
You will be crowned as an Iron Chef.
Iron Chef Gauntlet, now streaming on SBS On Demand.
$1 riff, a minute to learn, a lifetime to master. Or is that Hungry Hungry Hippo? Anyway, listen carefully and identify the songs from which the following riffs have been ripped. Orchestra, activate the riffs. Buzz in, but Ian will probably not believe in himself and will never get it out.
I'll name the band, Mark can name the title. Please. The Angels.
Correct, and what's the name of the song?
She Has No Secrets.
No Secrets is absolutely right. Working as a team. Riff number two.
It's Roxy Music.
Oh, what's the name of the song?
Love is a Drug.
Love is the Drug, absolutely. 4 points there. Oh, Brian Ferry. I just drifted off then. Riff number three. Mark, you did buzz in. What would you think it might be?
It's Warren Zevon and the Werewolves of London.
Werewolves of London. Brian and Dougal, what's the dip after the rest? Woo! Knowledge can be a dangerous thing. In the case of Master Blaster, a lot of knowledge is a damn good thing. Let's start with Catherine.
Oh, no.
And your topic, Hank Williams. Here we go. Where and when was Hank Williams born, and what was his birth name?
Hiram Williams, September 17, 1923. He was born in Georgiana, Alabama.
Absolutely correct. What was the last single to be released during Hank Williams' lifetime?
I'll Never Get Out of This World Alive.
Sadly, yes, that's absolutely correct. And indeed, he did not. Where was Hank when he passed away, and how old was he?
Oak Hill, Virginia, and he was 29.
Well done, Catherine. That's absolutely right. Well done, Catherine. Very good. And so now we turn our attention to Max. And your chosen area of sheer brilliance, Otis Redding. Very good. Now, what actually turned you on to Otis? What sort of made you come alive when you heard him for the first time?
The honesty. Hmm? And it got to me. Like, you know, just the plain, straight-ahead soul in the music, you know. It was honest.
Are you ready for your questions, Max Merritt?
I certainly am.
Certainly look like you are.
I brace myself.
Oof. Don't you get me started. How did Otis come to record his first songs at the legendary Stax Studios in Memphis?
He was a driver for the Pine Toppers, Johnny Jenkins and the Pine Toppers, and they had some spare time left over from the session, and he recorded, I can't record it. These Arms Are Mine.
Absolutely correct. Otis was a songwriter as well as an incredible performer. What was the song he co-wrote with Jerry Butler, who wrote Western Union Man?
I've been loving you too long.
Be serious, Max. What's the answer to the question? Oh, I've been loving you too long. Absolutely correct. Dock of the Bay was recorded just days before Otis died in a plane crash in 1967 and finished later by co-writer Steve Cropper. How did the famous whistling come about?
He was whistling the horn part, the saxophone part that was supposed to be played later on, but they just kept it in.
Absolutely correct, Max Merritt. 4 points. Bravo, Max and Catherine. You have our utmost R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Brian and Googled a quick tete-a-tete, then vite, vite, allez, rapide.
Welcome back, chefs. Here you are. Each week, there will be two challenges.
Boom.
I want it.
That's you. The winner survives. The loser leaves.
This is like straight up war.
The worst is yet to come.
Jeff, you're scaring me.
You have to beat 3 Iron Chefs.
You've got the consistency on the custard just right.
I like it. Thank you, Chef.
If you happen to succeed in this quest,
how much time?
You will be crowned as an Iron Chef.
Iron Chef Gauntlet, now streaming on SBS On Demand.
When you look at yourselves, what do you see? You are the cream of the French aristocracy. When I look at you, I see corruption, darkness, temptation, murder.
I will show you that I have no secrets.
Why should the people of France suffer for my sins? What must I do?
The new season of Versailles. Preview the first episode on SBS On Demand now.
For anyone who has ever felt invisible, for anyone...
That tree's amazing. That's our friend.
...who ever needed to find hope...
I can help you.
...comes a visually spectacular emotional journey. Critics rave. It's an unforgettable masterpiece.
You will like a thrill.
...that will make your spirit soar.
For this is why you called me. Come on.
A Monster Calls.
Oh my, our allotted time is almost up. The pace is quickening, the pressure's building, and the orchestra is playing this. Alrighty, concentration focused, check. Chakras aligned, check. Buttocks clenched, check. Just Mark, so you know, at the moment your team is on about 100 billion points. No, it's on about 140, was that right? And the opposing team is on about 85. So it's still technically anyone's game if people put their hands on the buzzers. Starting
now.
What was Bill Wyman's hit? Yes.
Je suis un rockstar.
Oh, je suis un rockstar. Je avais une résidence. Je habitais là. À la south de France. Voulez-vous come partir with me and come and rester là with me in France? Now, according to a recent magazine poll, who is responsible for the world's worst cover version of AC/DC's You Shook Me All Night Long?
Celine Dion.
You're absolutely correct. Thank you, Kathy. Which middle-of-the-road singer released an album of big band covers of heavy metal hits called In a Metal Mood, No More Mr. Nice Guy?
Paul Anka.
Oh, you're so close with Paul Anka. It's
Pat Boone.
Pat Boone is absolutely correct. Pat Boone's cover of Ozzy Osbourne's Crazy Train later became the theme song for which MTV celebrity series? Yes.
The Osbourne family.
Absolutely correct. Very good, Libby. True or false? Pat Boone and the Osbournes were once next door neighbours.
True.
Absolutely correct. Very good. Who was Elton John's wife? Yes.
Renata.
Very good.
Someone.
Renata Blauer is absolutely correct. Very good. Who is Elton John's husband? Yes.
David Furnish.
Well, look at you with your little gossip facts. Absolutely correct. What are the cautionary words whispered during 10cc's I'm Not In Love? Yes, Mark.
B-boys, they cry.
Absolutely correct. Full points. Very good. What sort of whispers do we associate with George Michael? Yes.
Careless.
And aren't they careless? Correct. That's absolutely right. What sort of Jack is John Farnham? Yes.
The Whispering Jack.
He's Whispering Jack. Absolutely correct. Who was Ray Brown's band?
Yes. Whispers.
The Whispers is correct. Do you feel a theme? What would you feed a cat? Yes.
Whiskers.
Whiskers is correct. To paraphrase Alain Toussaint, let's go from a whisper to a scream. The art of tonsil shredding has an important place in rock and roll. Identify the screamer, not the song, in the following songs. Yes, band. Yes.
Robert Plant.
Robert Plant is absolutely correct. Who's the screamer in this?
John Lennon.
John, well, we had a discussion. What song
Revolution,
do you think it is?
Wasn't it?
It's Revolution.
Yeah, Revolution. Who was
John?
The screamer? Oh.
Yoko.
Yoko. Yeah.
Bonus points for Yoko.
Pay that. Oh, we're paying that. It was actually Paul. It was John's song, but Paul's scream. What about this song?
Joe Cocker.
Joe Cocker's absolutely correct. Who was the British rocker who was the self-appointed head of the Monster Raving Loony Party? Yes.
Screaming Lord Sutch.
100 million points to you, Steve. Absolutely correct. What was Johnny O'Keefe's song about screaming?
You gotta shout.
Shout is absolutely
Three,
correct.
3, 2, 1.
Twins conjoined at the head, separating you will be difficult. Brian Dougald, scalpels please. Victorious. Congratulations by 5 points. Well done. Congratulations to both teams. And thank you at home for watching. Remember, until we meet again, a Rock Quiz Cyber Fix is just a couple of clicks away. And don't forget, as James Brown once said, I only got a 7th grade education, but I have a doctorate in funk, and I like to put that to good use. To take us out tonight, Max and Catherine are coming together on one of Max's best known and most loved songs. So long.
Watching you slipping away.
someone else is stealing you away from me. I see it written in your eyes, and you confirm it with your lies. Though the web you weave can hold me, I would rather that you told me where you wanna be. Whoa, you're slipping away. Slipping away. Said it's breaking me in two. Watching you slipping away.
How about one more time for Stewie?
Sonitus reverbus, which of course is Latin for faster, louder, and hey, how about a little bit of reverb? As usual, we are guided on this long and winding road by a man who has made the name Brian Nankervis his very own. Brian Nankervis!
Thank you, Julia. Thank you, and well done. We'd like to say well done to American biologist Jason Bond, who recently named a new species of spider after Neil Young. The species is unique in that after mating, the female kills the male, eats him, and then sings like a hurricane in a quavering, strangled voice.
Earlier tonight, we cast our net into the RockWiz live audience, hoping to snare a quartet of rock brainiacs to compete in tonight's show. Here they are, the catch of the day! Good evening, Ian.
Evening.
Evening, how are you?
I'm exceptionally well.
Now, Ian, would you like to share with us the first concert you ever went to?
It was 1968.
Ooh.
Surf Beach Lawn, Wild Colonial Club, The Loved Ones.
Oh, The Loved Ones, gee.
Gerry Humphries.
Did you have that moustache in 1968?
No.
You didn't, pity. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mark.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Mark, you've only got 20% vision, I understand. Yes,
sure
I'm very beautiful, just so you know, in case you were wondering. You can touch me any time tonight that you feel like it. Now, Mark, what was the first album you ever bought?
Oh, do I have to say?
Yes, I'm afraid you do, sadly.
ABBA's Super Trooper.
Thank you for sharing that with us, Mark. I appreciate it. Please welcome Steve as well. Hello, Steve. Share with us the first concert you ever went to, Steve.
Believe it or not, it was actually Cold Joy.
Cold Joy, who's just celebrated 50 years in the Australian rock industry.
Yeah, I don't think it was in his first couple of years that I saw him. I was thinking it was probably about mid-60s, 65, in the Picture Theatre in Kempsey.
Oh, that's gorgeous. Now, Libby, can I please have the first concert you ever went to?
1987.
Yeah.
Boondall, sunny Brisbane. Young Talent Time.
Young Talent Time. Hey, Mark, your Super Trooper's looking decidedly cool after that. Young Talent Time, was Danny there?
Danny was there in all her glory.
Really? Mm. Without all the injection work.
No, she looked relatively like a 15-year-old.
Like a 15-year-old? Oh, happy times. Of course, tonight's teams are a bit hollow shells without the two special musical guests standing by, ready to cross the threshold. Let's part the curtain of mystery, shall we? Who can it be now? I was born in Newcastle in 1984. My father's record collection introduced me to country artists like Loretta Lynn, Hank Williams, and Dolly Parton, and inspired me to begin performing and writing my own songs. Early in my career, I collaborated with Bill Chambers and Casey Chambers, but the real surprise was when Elton John bought my album and said he just loved my voice. Yes, Ian?
Catherine Britt.
Please make her very welcome, Catherine Britt!
lucky girl. She got the diamond, but I got the world. It's my oyster and it's full of pearls. So honey, tell me who's the lucky girl.
Thank you. Thanks for having me here.
Oh, glad. Now, look, here's an interesting little point. Now, firstly, I just have to say that nowadays, Catherine moves between the two ends, Nashville and Newcastle. Newcastle up north. So you live in Nashville now?
I do. I kind of, you know, go between the two a fair bit, 6 months here, 6 months there sort of thing. But I've been home for a while. I'm loving it just a little bit too much.
Now, I'm just wondering, you've got Elton John walking into a record shop going, that looks quite good, Herbie, listen. That girl, give her a call. Talk about it for 2 weeks, find a number. Does she have a manager? Let me do a bit of work. How weird is that?
It's pretty weird, yeah.
So
I mean,
did you get the call from him personally?
Not the first time, no. It was kind of like a, you know, his people, my people sort of thing.
Yes, yes, I get that all the time, yes.
Yes, yes. But no, he got in contact with me to come see him play, actually. He wanted me to come and see him play in Sydney. So I went down and met him backstage, and he was just lovely. You know, he was a big fan. I was like, really?
That
Are
is
you sure?
And then you recorded a song together.
Yeah, yeah, we recorded a duet that was released in America on country radio. So
I'm sure we can Google that or iTunes it or something with the intraminet that I don't know how to use at all. Well, it's interesting because when Catherine came here tonight, because she's not often in the country of Australia visiting, we got her on the show. Of course, she brought family with her, as you would. They want to come and see her perform. And in our pre-selection, of course, before the show, her father was pretty keen to get up here and see if he could, well, cut the mustard. Steve, what relation are you to Catherine Britt?
I've never seen her before in my life. Her, what? No, she's my daughter.
She is your daughter, ladies and gentlemen.
I can't believe that you're on the other team. I'm so going to lose.
Oh, you don't know who you've got next to you. I think you'll find...
Oh, no, no, not that I'm talking you guys down at all, but it's my dad's... encyclopedia.
Well, let's see if that actually works out tonight. Welcome, Catherine. Thank you.
Thank you.
Very excited to have you on board. Now, no hints, Catherine, because you've been out the back with our other guests swapping fruity anecdotes about Dougal. So, who can it be, maintenant? I formed my first band at the age of 15 to play in youth clubs around Christchurch, New Zealand. Now, look, you'd really be a bit embarrassed if you got it wrong.
Christchurch, New Zealand. I was at the ARIA Hall of Fame, and it's got to be Max Merritt. Christchurch, 15.
Please, make him very welcome, Max Merritt!
Hey, Western Union man, send a telegram to my baby. Send a telegram. Send it on to my baby. Gonna make it all right. Listen. Tell her that I'm all alone. Try to call her on the phone. Tell her I'm in misery. Think that she's a boy to me. If a telegram won't do, send a box of candy too. Maybe some flowers. Tell her that I'm missing for hours and hours. Send a telegram. Send it on to my baby. Gonna make it all right. All right. Western Union man. Send a telegram to my baby. Western Union man. Send a telegram. Send it on to a baby. Gonna make it all right. Listen. Tell her that I'm all alone. Try to follow her on the phone. Have you got a boy can sing? Send him out right away. Maybe tomorrow. Maybe right away. I want a girl to know that I miss her. Something like yesterday. Send a telegram. Send it on to my baby. Gonna make it all right. Western Union man. Send a telegram to my baby. send a telegram. Send a telegram, send a telegram. Send it out to my baby. Gonna make it all right. Bye, Bob.
To Max. And your chosen area of sheer brilliance, Otis Redding. Very good. Now, what actually turned you on to Otis? What sort of made you come alive when you heard him for the first time?
The honesty. Hmm? And it got to me, like, you know, just the plain, straight-ahead soul in the music, you know. It was honest.
Are you ready for your questions, Max Maris?
I certainly am.
You certainly look like you are.
I'll brace myself.
Oof, don't you get me started. How did Otis come to record his first songs at the legendary Stax Studios in Memphis?
He was a driver for the Pine Toppers, Johnny Jenkins and the Pine Toppers, and they had some spare time left over from the session, and he recorded, I can't record it. These Arms Are Mine.
Absolutely correct. Otis was a songwriter as well as an incredible performer. What was the song he co-wrote with Jerry Butler, who wrote Western Union Man?
I've been loving you too long.
Be serious, Max. What's the answer to the question? Oh, I've been loving you too long. Absolutely correct. Dock of the Bay was recorded just days before Otis died in a plane crash in 1967 and finished later by co-writer Steve Cropper. How did the famous whistling come about?
He was whistling the horn part, the saxophone part that was supposed to be played later on, but they just kept it in.
Absolutely correct, Max Merritt. 4 points. Bravo, Max and Catherine. You have our utmost R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Brian and Dougald, a quick tête-à-tête, then vite, vite, allez, rapide.
Welcome back, chefs. Here you are. Each week, there will be 2 challenges.
Boom.
I want it.
That's you. The winner survives, the loser leaves.
This is like straight up war.
The worst is yet to come.
Jeff, you're scaring me.
You have to beat 3 Iron Chefs.
You've got the consistency on the custard just right.
I like it. Thank you, Chef.
If you happen to succeed in this quest,
how much time?
You will be crowned as an Iron Chef.
Iron Chef Gauntlet, now streaming on SBS On Demand.
When you look at yourselves, what do you see? You are the cream of the French aristocracy. When I look at you, I see corruption, darkness, temptation, murder.
I will show you that I have no secrets.
Why should the people of France suffer for my sins? What must I do?
The new season of Versailles. Preview the first episode on SBS On Demand now.
For anyone who has ever felt invisible, for anyone...
That tree's amazing. That's our friend.
...whoever needed to find hope...
I can help you.
...comes a visually spectacular emotional journey. Critics rave. It's an unforgettable masterpiece...
You will like a thrill.
...that will make your spirit soar.
For this is why you called me. Come on.
A Monster Calls.
Oh my, our allotted time is almost up. The pace is quickening, the pressure's building, and the orchestra is playing this. Alrighty, concentration focused, check. Chakras aligned, check. Buttocks clenched, check. Just mark so you know, at the moment your team is on about 100 billion points. No, it's on about 140, was that right? And the opposing team is on about 85. So it's still technically anyone's game if people put their hands on the buzzers. Starting
now.
What was Bill Wyman's hit? Yes.
Je suis un rockstar.
Oh, je suis un rockstar. Je avais une résidence. Je habitais là. À la south de France. Voulez-vous come partir with me and come and rester là with me in France? Now, according to a recent magazine poll, who is responsible for the world's worst cover version of AC/DC's You Shook Me All Night Long?
Celine Dion.
You're absolutely correct. Thank you, Catherine. Which middle-of-the-road singer released an album of big band covers of heavy metal hits called In a Metal Mood, No More Mr. Nice Guy?
Paul Anka.
Oh, you're so close with Paul Anka.
It's Pat Boone.
Pat Boone is absolutely correct. Pat Boone's cover of Ozzy Osbourne's Crazy Train later became the theme song for which MTV celeb reality series? Yes.
The Osbourne Family.
Absolutely correct. Very good, Libby. True or false? Pat Boone and the Osbournes were once next-door neighbours.
True.
Absolutely correct. Very good. Who was Elton John's wife? Yes.
Renata.
Very good.
Someone.
Renata Blauer is absolutely correct. Very good. Who is Elton John's husband? Yes.
David Furnish.
Look at you with your little gossip facts. Absolutely correct. What are the cautionary words whispered during 10cc's I'm Not In Love? Yes, Mark.
Big boys, they cry.
Absolutely correct. Full points. Very good. What sort of whispers do we associate with George Michael? Yes.
Careless.
And aren't they careless? Correct. That's absolutely right. What sort of jack is John...
I'm pretty good.
Yeah, look.
I'm pretty good. Remarkable for a man of my vintage.
Remarkable indeed. Now, of course, you were inducted, you freak, into the ARIA Hall of Fame. I mean, he guessed you in a sentence and a half, Christchurch, New Zealand. Apparently gave her away. How was that? How did you go at the ARIA Hall of Fame that night?
How did I go?
Mm.
You were there.
I know I was there, but they weren't. So I'm just saying maybe you could... Was it a good night?
It was remarkable. It was great.
Yeah.
Wonderful, a very moving, very emotional evening for everybody.
Yeah. You supported the Stones, the Rolling Ones, at one point. What in the world was that tour like?
It was great. It was exciting. You know, we were kids. We were young, let's put it that way. And to be in the midst of all that confusion and the delirium, you know, was fabulous.
Now, Mr. Merritt, could you share with us the first concert you ever went to? I'm very keen to hear.
It was the Platters, Tommy Sand and Johnny O'Keefe.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Max Merritt, welcome to Rock Quiz. We are absolutely delighted to have
you
on the show and with Catherine as well. It's a beautiful combo. All right, the pleasantries, as always, have been pleasant. But for the uninitiated, this is the way the show starts, not with a whimper, but with a bang. Oh, as T.S. Eliot said, here we go round the prickly pear at 5 o'clock in the morning. What he really meant was, hands on buzzers. Let's play. Who sang Ma Belle? Sont des mots qui vont très bien ensemble.
The Beatles?
The Beatles is correct, absolutely. What about a translation for Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir? Yes. Oh, yes, Steve.
Will you sleep with me tonight?
Well, no, I can't sleep with you tonight because it's utterly inappropriate. But that's absolutely correct right there. Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir? Lady Marmalade, of course, nothing about a couch, coucher, or furniture. It's about sex, as usual. And who sang that song?
La Belle.
La Belle is correct. Name one of Janis Joplin's backing bands. Yes, Ian.
Full Tilt Boogie Band. Full Tilt. Well, the Full Tilt Boogie Band.
Right, that's absolutely correct, Ian. I'm glad you said it twice. That's good.
I'm trying to think of the first one.
Here is the single, name the album that it originally appeared on. Son of a Preacher Man, Dusty Springfield. Yes, Ian.
It's not Dusty in Memphis.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, it is. It is Dusty in Memphis.
Walk on the Wild Side, Lou Reed. What album is it off? Yes, Mark.
Transformer.
That's great, absolutely. Never Tear Us Apart by INXS. Yes.
Kick.
Kick is absolutely correct, very good. The Eurythmics, Would I Lie to You? Yes.
Be Yourself Tonight.
Oh, absolutely correct, well done. Can you give me a year, Mark?
Yeah, came out in the middle of 1985.
Oh, hello, absolutely correct, very good. Cheap Wine, Cold Chisel, yes.
Not East, it's the...
No, it is.
Yes, it's East.
It is East, I said it.
Ian, you must believe in yourself.
I know.
Maybe that involves shaving off that moustache. I don't know.
Who famously duetted with these singers? Tammy Wynette. Yes.
George Jones.
George Jones, I will accept. I would have accepted KLF as well. It's a bit hard on the ears. Sorry about that. Graham Parsons. Yes.
Emmylou Harris.
Oh, you're on the ball there, Steve. Correct. Now, complete this lyric, singing, if possible, and name the song and artist. She's got a smile that it seems to me
reminds me of childhood memories where everything was as fresh as a bright blue sky.
Who sings that, Catherine?
Guns N' Roses.
What's the name of the song?
Sweet Child of Mine.
15 points. Complete this lyric. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone.
Ain't no love when she's away.
That's absolutely right.
Ain't no sunshine since she's gone. She's always gone too long. Anytime she goes away.
I could fall in love with you, Max Merrick.
Please do.
Please do. What's the name of the song?
Ain't no sunshine since she's gone.
Who sang it?
Bill Withers.
Would you like 15 points? 15 points right now! Oh. Complete this lyric. Oh, she may be weary.
Young girls do get weary. Wearing that same... I can't sing it, Max, but I adore that
commit,
song.
Commit, commit,
well, when she gets weary, try a little tenderness.
Are you trying to crack on again? Title of the song?
Hmm?
Title of
try
the song?
Try a little tenderness.
Who sang
Otis
it?
Redding.
Of course he did. 15 points right there.
His interpretation was as good, if not better, than Otis's.
Oh, round of applause. I think we'd all agree to that.
From open spaces to colourful cities, together we are one country. SBS and NITV connect you with our rich Indigenous culture through fascinating, entertaining and informative stories.
The Southern Cross is an emu footprint.
When you lift his feet up, you put his footprints there, you come a Southern Cross.
I'd like to go to the ceremony because I want to be a man.
I believe the Yes I Can is the answer to my community.
Let SBS and NITV take you on a journey. Walk with us.
For anyone who has ever felt invisible, for anyone...
That tree's amazing. That's our friend.
...whoever needed to find hope...
I can help you.
...comes a visually spectacular emotional journey. Critics rave. It's an unforgettable masterpiece.
You will like a thrill.
...that will make your spirit soar.
For this is why you called me. Come on.
A Monster Calls...
Welcome back, chefs. Here you are. Each week, there will be two challenges.
Boom.
I want it.
That's you. The winner survives, the loser leaves.
This is like straight up war.
The worst is yet to come.
Jeff, you're scaring me.
You have to beat three Iron Chefs.
You've got the consistency on the custard just right.
I like it. Thank you, Chef.
If you happen to succeed in this quest,
how much time?
You will be crowned as an Iron Chef.
Iron Chef Gauntlet, now streaming on SBS On Demand.
$1 riff, a minute to learn, a lifetime to master. Or is that Hungry Hungry Hippo? Anyway, listen carefully and identify the songs from which the following riffs have been ripped. Orchestra, activate the riffs. In, but Ian will probably not believe in himself and will never get it out.
I'll Ian. Name the band, Mark can name the title. Please. The Angels.
Correct, and what's the name of the song?
She Has No Secrets.
No Secrets is absolutely right. Working as a team. Riff number two.
It's Roxy Music.
Oh, what's the name of the song?
Love is a Drug.
Love is the Drug, absolutely. 4 points there. Oh, Brian Ferry. Mm-mm. I just drifted off then. Riff number three. Mark, you did buzz in. What would you think it might be?
It's Warren Zevon and the Werewolves of London.
Werewolves of London. Brian and Dougal, what's the gift after the rest? Knowledge can be a dangerous thing. In the case of Master Blaster, a lot of knowledge is a damn good thing. Let's start with Catherine.
Oh, no.
And your topic, Hank Williams. Here we go. Where and when was Hank Williams born and what was his birth name?
Hiram Williams, September 17, 1923. He was born in Georgiana, Alabama.
Absolutely correct. What was the last single to be released during Hank Williams' lifetime?
I'll Never Get Out of This World Alive.
Sadly, yes, that's absolutely correct. And indeed, he did not. Where was Hank when he passed away and how old was he?
Oak Hill, Virginia, and he was 29.
Well done, Catherine. That's absolutely right. Well done, Catherine. Very good. And so now...
Lucky boy, did you tell her she's your second choice? 'Cause I wouldn't be your little toy. Ain't no man inside her, lucky boy. Guess you finally found someone who's everything that I could be. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I just couldn't see myself as Mrs. You Gonna Walk. Tell me who's the lucky girl. That's right. She got the diamond, but I got the world. It's my oyster and it's full of pearls. So honey, tell me who's the lucky girl.
Welcome, Catherine.
Thank you. Thanks for having me here.
Oh, glad. Now, look, here's an interesting little point. Now, firstly, I just have to say that nowadays, Catherine moves between the two ends, Nashville and Newcastle. Newcastle up north. So you live in Nashville now?
I do. I kind of, you know, go between the two a fair bit, 6 months here, 6 months there sort of thing. But I've been home for a while. I'm loving it just a little bit too much.
Now, I'm just wondering, you've got Elton John walking into a record shop going, that looks quite good, Hobie Lewson. That girl, give her a call. Talk about it for 2 weeks, find a number. Does she have a manager? Let me do a bit of work. How weird's that?
It's pretty weird, yeah.
So
did
you get the call from him personally?
Not the first time, no. It was kind of like a, you know, his people, my people sort of thing.
Yes, I get that all the time, yes.
Yes. But no, he got in contact with me to come see him play, actually. He wanted me to come and see him play in Sydney. So I went down and met him backstage, and he was just lovely. You know, he was a big fan. I was like, really?
Are you sure? And then you recorded a song together.
Yeah, we recorded a duet that was released in America.
One!
Joined at the head, separating you will be difficult. Brian Dougald, scalpels please. Victorious. Congratulations by 5 points. Well done. Congratulations to both teams. And thank you at home for watching. Remember, until we meet again, a Rock Quiz Cyber Fix is just a couple of clicks away. And don't forget, as James Brown once said, I only got a seventh grade education, but I have a doctorate in funk, and I like to put that to good use. To take us out tonight, Max and Catherine are coming together on one of Max's best known and most loved songs. So long.
Fabulous.
Now, Mr. Merritt, could you share with us the first concert you ever went to? I'm very keen to hear.
It was the Platters, Tommy Sand and Johnny O'Keefe.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Max Merritt, welcome to Rock Quiz. We are absolutely delighted to have
you
on the show and with Catherine as well. It's a beautiful combo. All right, the pleasantries, as always, have been pleasant. But for the uninitiated, this is the way the show starts, not with a whimper, but with a bang. Oh, as T.S. Eliot said, here we go round the prickly pear at 5 o'clock in the morning. What he really meant was, hands on buzzers. Let's play. Who sang Ma belle, sont des mots qui vont très bien ensemble?
The Beatles?
The Beatles is correct, absolutely. What about a translation for Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir? Yes, oh, yes, Steve.
Will you sleep with me tonight?
Well, no, I can't sleep with you tonight because it's utterly inappropriate, but that's absolutely correct right there. Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir? Lady Marmalade, of course, nothing about a couch, coucher, or furniture. It's about sex, as usual. And who sang that song? Voulez-vous coucher avec moi? Yep.
La Belle.
La Belle is correct. Name one of Janis Joplin's backing bands. Yes, Ian.
Full Tilt Boogie Band. Full Tilt. Well, Full Tilt Boogie Band.
Right, that's absolutely correct, Ian. I'm glad you said it twice. That's good.
I'm trying to think of the first one.
Here is the single. Name the album that it originally appeared on. Son of a Preacher Man, Dusty Springfield. Yes, Ian.
It's not Dusty in Memphis.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, it is. It is Dusty in Memphis.
Is Walk on the Wild Side, Lou Reed. What album is it off? Yes, Mark.
Transformer.
That's great, absolutely. Never Tear Us Apart by INXS. Yes.
Kick.
Kick is absolutely correct, very good. The Eurythmics, Would I Lie to You? Yes.
Be Yourself Tonight.
Oh, absolutely correct, well done. Can you give me a year, Mark?
Yeah, come out in the middle of 1985.
Oh, hello, absolutely correct, very good. Good evening and welcome to Rock Quiz, where our motto is Sitius Sonitus Reverbus, which of course is Latin for faster, louder, and hey, how about a little bit of reverb? As usual, we are guided on this long and winding road by a man who has made the name Brian Nankervis his very own. Brian Nankervis!
Thank you, Julia. Thank you, and well done. We'd like to say well done to American biologist Jason Bond, who recently named a new species of spider after Neil Young. The species is unique in that after mating, the female kills the male, eats him, and then sings like a hurricane in a quavering, strangled voice.
Earlier tonight, we cast our net into the RockWiz live audience, hoping to snare a quartet of rock brainiacs to compete in tonight's show. Here they are, the catch of the day!
Evening.
Evening. How are you?
I'm exceptionally well.
Now, Ian, would you like to share with us the first concert you ever went to?
It was 1968.
Ooh.
Surf Beach Lawn, Wild Colonial Club, The Loved Ones.
Oh, The Loved Ones. Gee.
Gary Humphries.
Did you have that moustache in 1968?
No.
You didn't. Pity. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mark.
Thank you. Thank you.
You've only got 20% vision, I understand. Yes,
sure
I'm
do.
Very beautiful, just so you know, in case you're wondering. You can touch me any time tonight that you feel like it. Now, Mark, what was the first album you ever bought?
Oh, do I have to say?
Yes, I'm afraid you do, sadly.
ABBA's Super Trooper.
Thank you for sharing that with us, Mark. I appreciate it. Please welcome Steve as well. Hello, Steve. share with us the first concert you ever went to, Steve?
Believe it or not, it was actually Cold Joy.
Cold Joy, who's just celebrated 50 years in the Australian rock industry.
Yeah, I don't think it was in his first couple of years that I saw him. I was thinking it was probably about mid-60s, 65, in the Picture Theatre in Kempsey.
Oh, that's gorgeous. Now, Libby, can I please have the first concert you ever went to?
1987?
Yeah.
Boom.
That's the first concert you ever went to. I'm very keen to hear.
It was the Platters, Tommy Sand and Johnny O'Keefe.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Max Merritt, welcome to Rock Quiz. We are absolutely delighted to have you on the show and with Catherine as well. It's a beautiful combo. All right, the pleasantries, as always, have been pleasant. But for the uninitiated, this is the way the show starts, not with a whimper, but with a bang. As T.S. Eliot said, here we go round the prickly pear at 5 o'clock in the morning. What he really meant was, hands on buzzers. Let's play. Who sang Ma belle, sont des mots qui vont très bien ensemble?
The Beatles.
The Beatles is correct, absolutely. What about a translation for Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir? Yes, oh, yes, Steve.
Will you sleep with me tonight?
Well, no, I can't sleep with you tonight because it's utterly inappropriate. But that's absolutely correct right there. Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir? Lady Marmalade, of course, nothing about a couch, coucher, or furniture. It's about sex, as usual. And who sang that song? Voulez-vous coucher avec moi? Yep.
La Belle.
La Belle is correct. Name one of Janis Joplin's backing bands. Yes, Ian.
Full Tilt Boogie Band. Full Tilt. Well, the Full Tilt Boogie Band.
Right, that's absolutely correct, Ian. I'm glad you said it twice. That's good.
I'm trying to think of the first one.
Here is the single. Name the album that it originally appeared on. Son of a Preacher Man, Dusty Springfield. Yes, Ian.
It's not Dusty in Memphis.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, it is. It is Dusty in Memphis.
Correct! The single is Walk on the Wild Side, Lou Reed. What album is it off? Yes, Mark.
Transformer.
That's great, absolutely. Never Tear Us Apart by INXS. Yes.
Kick.
Kick is absolutely correct. Very good. The Eurythmics, Would I Lie to You? Yes.
Be Yourself Tonight.
Oh, absolutely correct. Well done. Can you give me a year, Mark?
Yeah, came out in the middle of 1985.
Oh, hello. Absolutely correct. Very good. Cheap Wine, Cold Chisel. Yes.
Not East, it's the...
No, it is.
Yes, it's East. Stuff on Hammond and Telecaster. James, bulging bicep, black! And now, to incorrectly quote Dusty Springfield, the only boy who could ever reach her was the son of a pizza man, super and supreme, your host, Julia DeMera!
Welcome to Rock Quiz, where our motto is Sitius Sonitus Reverbus, which of course is Latin for faster, louder, and hey, how about a little bit of reverb? As usual, we are guided on this long and winding road by a man who has made the name Brian Nankervis his very own. Brian Nankervis!
Thank you, Julia. Thank you, and well done. We'd like to say well done to American biologist Jason Bond, who recently named a new species of spider after Neil Young. The species is unique in that after mating, the female kills the male, eats him, and then sings like a hurricane in a quavering, strangled voice.
Earlier tonight, we cast our net into the RockWiz live audience, hoping to snare a quartet of rock brainiacs to compete in tonight's show. Here they are, the catch of the day!
Evening.
Evening. How are you?
I'm exceptionally well.
Now, Ian, would you like to share with us the first concert you ever went to?
It was 1968.
Ooh.
Surf Beach Lawn, Wild Colonial Club, The Loved Ones.
Oh, The Loved Ones. Gee.
Gerry Humphries.
Did you have that moustache in 1968?
No.
You didn't. Pity. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mark.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Mark, you've only got 20% vision, I understand. Yes,
sure
I'm very beautiful. Just so you know, in case you're wondering, you can touch me any time tonight that you feel like it. Now, Mark, what was the first album you ever bought?
Oh, do I have to say?
Yes, I'm afraid you do, sadly.
ABBA's Super Trooper.
Thank you for sharing that with us, Mark. I appreciate it. Please welcome Steve as well. Hello, Steve. Share with us the first concert you ever went to, Steve.
Believe it or not, it was actually Cold Joy.
Cold Joy, who's just...
Welcome back, chefs. Here you are. Each week, there will be two challenges.
Boom!
I want it.
That's you. The winner survives, the loser leaves.
This is like straight up war.
The worst is yet to come.
Jeff, you're scaring me.
You have to beat three Iron Chefs.
You've got the consistency on the custard just right.
I like it. Thank you, Chef.
If you happen to succeed in this quest...
How much time?
You will be crowned as an Iron Chef.
Iron Chef Gauntlet, now streaming on SBS On Demand.
When you look at yourselves, what do you see? You are the cream of the French aristocracy. When I look at you, I see corruption, darkness, temptation, murder.
I will show you that I have no secrets.
Why should the people of France suffer for my sins? What must I do?
The new season of Versailles. Preview the first episode on SBS On Demand now.
For anyone who has ever felt invisible, for anyone...
That tree's amazing. That's our friend.
...whoever needed to find hope...
I can help you.
...comes a visually spectacular emotional journey. Critics rave. It's an unforgettable masterpiece.
You will like a thrill.
...that will make your spirit soar.
For this is why you called me. Come on.
A Monster Calls.
Oh my, a lot of time is almost up, the pace is quickening, the pressure's building, and the orchestra is playing this. Alrighty, concentration focused, check. Chakras aligned, check. Buttocks clenched, check. Just Mark, so you know, at the moment your team is on about 100 billion points. No, it's on about 140, was that right? And the opposing team is on about 85. So it's still technically anyone's game if people put their hands on the buzzers. Starting...
now.
What was Bill Wyman's hit? Yes.
Je suis un rockstar.
Oh, je suis un rockstar. Je avais une résidence. Je habitais là. À la south de France. Voulez-vous come partir with me and come and rester là with me in France? Now, according to a recent magazine poll, who is responsible for the world's worst cover version of AC/DC's You Shook Me All Night Long?
Celine Dion.
You're absolutely correct. Thank you, Kathy. Which middle-of-the-road singer released an album of big band covers of heavy metal hits called In a Metal Mood, No More Mr. Nice Guy?
Paul Anka.
Oh, you're so close with Paul Anka. It's
Pat Boone.
Pat Boone is absolutely correct.
Welcome back, chefs. Here you are. Each week, there will be two challenges.
Boom!
I want it.
That's you. The winner survives, the loser leaves.
This is like straight up war.
The worst is yet to come.
Jeff, you're scaring me.
You have to beat three Iron Chefs.
You've got the consistency on the custard just right.
I like it. Thank you, Chef.
If you happen to succeed in this quest,
how much time?
You will be crowned as an Iron Chef.
Iron Chef Gauntlet, now streaming on SBS On Demand.
When you look at yourselves, what do you see? You are the cream of the French aristocracy. When I look at you, I see corruption, darkness, temptation, murder.
I will show you that I have no secrets.
Why should the people of France suffer for my sins? What must I do?
The new season of Versailles. Preview the first episode on SBS On Demand now.
For anyone who has ever felt invisible, for anyone...
That tree's amazing. That's our friend.
...whoever needed to find hope...
I can help you.
...comes a visually spectacular emotional journey. Critics rave. It's an unforgettable masterpiece.
You will like a thrill.
...that will make your spirit soar.
For this is why you called me. Come on.
A Monster Calls.
Oh my, there are a lot of time is almost up, the pace is quickening, the pressure's building, and the orchestra is playing this. Alrighty, concentration focused, check. Chakras aligned, check. Buttocks clenched, check. Just mark so you know, at the moment your team is on about 100 billion points. No, it's on about 140, was that right? And the opposing team is on about 85. So it's still technically anyone's game if people put their hands on the buzzers. Starting...
now.
What was Bill Wyman's hit? Yes.
Je suis un rockstar.
Oh, je suis un rockstar. Je avais une résidence. Je habitais là. À la south de France. Voulez-vous come partir with me and come and rester là with me in France? Now, according to a recent magazine poll, who is responsible for the world's worst cover version of AC/DC's You Shook Me All Night Long?
Celine Dion.
You're absolutely correct. Thank you, Kathy. Which middle-of-the-road singer released an album of big band covers of heavy metal hits called In A Minute?
Yes, you finally found the one who's everything that I couldn't be. Whoa, 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 I just couldn't see myself as missing you more. Girl.
Welcome, Catherine.
Thank you. Thanks for having me here.
Oh, glad. Now, look, here's an interesting little point. Now, firstly, I just have to say that nowadays, Catherine moves between the two ends, Nashville and Newcastle. Newcastle up north. So you live in Nashville now?
I do. I kind of, you know, go between the two a fair bit, 6 months here, 6 months there sort of thing. But I've been home for a while. I'm loving it just a little bit too much.
Now, I'm just wondering, you've got Elton John walking into a record shop going, that looks quite good, have a listen. That girl, give her a call. Talk about it for 2 weeks, find a number. Does she have a manager? Let me do a bit of work. How weird is that?
It's pretty weird, yeah.
But
I mean,
did you get the call from him personally?
Not the first time, no. It was kind of like a, you know, his people, my people sort of thing.
Yes, yes, I get that all the time, yes.
Yes, yes. But no, he got in contact with me to come see him play, actually. He wanted me to come and see him play in Sydney. So I went down and met him backstage, and he was just lovely. You know, he was a big fan. I was like, really?
That
Are
is
you sure?
And then you recorded a song together.
Yeah, yeah, we recorded a duet that was released in America on country radio. So
I'm sure we can Google that or iTunes it or something with the intraminet that I don't know how to use at all. Well, it's interesting because when Catherine came here tonight, because she's not often in the country of Australia visiting, we got her on the show. Of course, she brought family with her, as you would. They want to come and see her perform. And in our pre-selection, of course, before the show, her father was pretty keen to get up here and see if he could, well, cut the mustard. Steve, what relation are you to Catherine Britt?
I've never seen her before in my life. What? No, she's my daughter.
She is your daughter, ladies and gentlemen.
I can't believe that you're on the other team. I'm so going to lose.
Oh, you don't know who you've got next to you. I think you're fine. Oh, no, not that I'm talking you guys down at all, but it's my dad's a encyclopedia. Well, let's see if that actually works out tonight. Welcome, Catherine. Thank you. Very excited to have you on board. Now, no hints, Catherine, because you've been out the back with our other guests swapping fruity anecdotes about Dougal. So, who sang that song?
La Belle.
La Belle is correct. Name one of Janis Joplin's backing bands. Yes, Ian.
Full Tilt Boogie Band. Full Tilt. Well, Full Tilt Boogie Band.
Right, that's absolutely correct, Ian. I'm glad you said it twice. That's good.
I'm trying to think of the first one.
Here is the single. Name the album that it originally appeared on. Son of a Preacher Man, Dusty Springfield. Yes, Ian.
It's not Dusty in Memphis.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, it is. It is Dusty in Memphis.
Correct! The single is Walk on the Wild Side, Lou Reed. What album is it off? Yes, Mark.
Transformer.
That's great, absolutely! Never Tear Us Apart by INXS. Yes.
Kick.
Kick is absolutely correct. Very good. The Eurythmics, Would I Lie to You? Yes.
Be Yourself Tonight.
Oh, absolutely correct. Well done. Can you give me a year, Mark?
Yeah, came out in the middle of 1985.
Oh, hello. Absolutely correct. Very good. Cheap Wine, Cold Chisel. Yes.
Not East, it's the...
No, it is.
Yes, it's East.
It is East. I said it.
Ian, you must believe in yourself. Maybe that involves shaving off that moustache. I don't know.
Who famously duetted with these singers? Tammy Wynette. Yes.
George Jones.
George Jones, I will accept. I would have accepted KLF as well. It's a bit hard on the ears. Sorry about that. Graham Parsons. Yes.
Emmylou Harris.
Oh, you're on the ball there, Steve. Correct. Now, complete this lyric, singing, if possible, and name the song and artist. She's got a smile that it seems to me
reminds me of childhood memories where everything was as fresh as a bright blue sky.
Who sings that, Catherine?
Guns N' Roses.
What's the name of the song?
Sweet Child of Mine.
15 points. Complete this lyric. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone.
Ain't no love when she's away.
That's absolutely right.
Ain't no sunshine since she's gone. She's always gone too long. Anytime she goes.
Who was Ray Brown's band?
Yes. Whispers.
The Whispers is correct. Do you feel a theme? What would you feed a cat? Yes.
Whiskers.
Whiskers is correct. To paraphrase Alain Toussaint, let's go from a whisper to a scream. The art of tonsil shredding has an important place in rock and roll. Identify the screamer, not the song, in the following songs. Yes, band. Yes.
Robert Plant.
Robert Plant is absolutely correct. Who's the screamer in this? Yes?
John Lennon.
John, well, we had a discussion. What song
Revolution,
do you think it is?
Won't
it? It's Revolution.
But who was the screamer? Oh.
Yoko.
Yoko.
Yeah. Bonus points for Yoko.
Pay that. Oh, we're paying that. It was actually Paul. It was John's song, but Paul's scream. What about this song?
Joe Cocker.
Joe Cocker's absolutely correct. Who was the British Chris Rocker, who was the self-appointed head of the Monster Raving Loony Party. Yes.
Screaming Lord Sutch.
100 million points to you, Steve. Absolutely correct. What was Johnny O'Keefe's song about screaming?
You gotta shout.
Shout is absolutely
Three,
correct.
3, 2, 1.
That's it. Teams like twins conjoined at the head. Separating you will be difficult. Brian Dougald, scalpels please. Victorious. Congratulations by 5 points. Well done. Congratulations to both teams. And thank you at home for watching. Remember, until we meet again, a Rock Quiz Cyber Fix is just a couple of clicks away. And don't forget, as James Brown once said, I only got a seventh grade education, but I have a doctorate in funk, and I like to put that to good use. To take us out tonight, Max and Catherine are coming together on one of Max's best known and most loved songs. So long.
I can't record it. These arms are mine.
Absolutely correct. Otis was a songwriter as well as an incredible performer. What was the song he co-wrote with Jerry Butler, who wrote Western Union Man?
I've been loving you too long.
Be serious, Max. What's the answer to the question? Oh, I've been loving you too long. Absolutely correct. Dock of the Bay was recorded just days before Otis died in a plane crash in 1967 and finished later by co-writer Steve Cropper. How did the famous whistling come about?
He was whistling the horn part, the saxophone part that was supposed to be played later on, but they just kept it in.
Absolutely correct, Max Merritt. 4 points. Bravo, Max and Catherine. You have our utmost R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Brian and Dougald, a quick tête-à-tête, then vite, vite, allez, rapide.
Welcome back, chefs. Here you are. Each week, there will be two challenges.
Boom.
I want it.
That's you.
The winner survives, the loser leaves.
This is like straight up war.
The worst is yet to come.
Jeff, you're scaring me.
You have to beat 3 Iron Chefs.
You've got the consistency on the custard just right.
I like it. Thank you, chef.
If you happen to succeed in this quest,
how much time?
You will be crowned as an Iron Chef.
Iron Chef Gauntlet, now streaming on SBS On Demand.
When you look at yourselves, what do you see? You are the cream of the French aristocracy. When I look at you, I see corruption, darkness, temptation, murder.
I will show you that I have no secrets.
Why should the people of France suffer for my sins? What must I do?
The new season of Versailles. Preview the first episode on SBS On Demand now.
For anyone who has ever felt invisible, for anyone...
That tree's amazing. That's our friend.
...whoever needed to find hope...
I can help you.
...comes a visually spectacular emotional journey. Critics rave. It's an unforgettable masterpiece.
You will make a thrill.
...that will make your spirits soar.
For this is why you called me. Come on.
A Monster Calls.
Oh, my. Errol Adam and said he just loved my voice. Yes, Ian?
Catherine Britt.
Please make her very welcome, Catherine Britt.
Lucky Clara. my oyster and it's full of pearls. So honey, tell me who's the lucky girl. Lucky boy, did you tell her she's your second choice? 'Cause I wouldn't be your little toy.
Thank you. Thanks for having me here.
Oh, glad. Now, look, here's an interesting little point. Now, firstly, I just have to say that nowadays, Catherine moves between the two ends, Nashville and Newcastle. Newcastle up north. So you live in Nashville now?
I do. I kind of, you know, go between the two a fair bit, 6 months here, 6 months there sort of thing. But I've been home for a while. I'm loving it just a little bit too much.
Now, I'm just wondering, you've got Elton John walking into a record shop going, that looks quite good, Herb Lewson.
That's a telegram. Send a telegram to my baby, Western Union man. Send a telegram, send a telegram, send a telegram. Send it out to my baby, gonna make it all right. All right, bud. I'm pretty good.
Yeah, look.
I'm pretty good. Remarkable for a man of my vintage.
Remarkable indeed. Now, of course, you were inducted, you freak, into the ARIA Hall of Fame. I mean, he guessed you in a sentence and a half, Christchurch, New Zealand, apparently gave her away. How was that? How did you go at the ARIA Hall of Fame that night?
How did I go? You were there.
I know I was there, but they weren't. So I'm just saying, maybe could you... Was it a good night?
It was remarkable. It was great.
Yeah.
Wonderful, a very moving, very emotional evening for everybody.
Yeah. You supported the Stones, the Rolling Ones, at one point. What in the world was that tour like?
It was great. It was exciting. You know, we were kids. We were young, let's put it that way. And to be in the midst of all that confusion and the delirium, you know, was fabulous.
Now, Mr. Merritt, could you share with us the first concert you ever went to? I'm very keen to hear.
It was the Platters, Tommy Sand and Johnny O'Keefe.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Max Merritt, welcome to Rockquiz. We are absolutely delighted to have you on the show and with Catherine as well. It's a beautiful combo. All right, the pleasantries, as always, have been pleasant. But for the uninitiated, this is the way the show starts. Not with a whimper, but with a bang.
Hello.
T.S. Eliot said, here we go round the prickly pear at 5 o'clock in the morning. What he really meant was, hands on buzzers. Let's play. Who sang Ma belle, sont des mots qui vont très bien ensemble?
The Beatles?
The Beatles is correct, absolutely. What about a translation for Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir? Yes, oh, yes, Steve.
Will you sleep with me tonight?
Well, no, I can't sleep with you tonight because it's utterly inappropriate, but that's absolutely correct right there. Brian and Dougal, it's early days.
From open spaces to colourful cities, together we are one country. SBS and NITV connect you with our rich Indigenous culture through fascinating, entertaining and informative stories.
The Southern Cross is an emu footprint.
When you lift his feet up, you put his footprints there, you become a Southern Cross.
I'd like to go to the ceremony because I want to be a man.
I believe the Yes I Can is the answer to my community.
Let SBS and NITV take you on a journey. Walk with us.
For anyone who has ever felt invisible, for anyone...
That tree's amazing. That's our friend.
...whoever needed to find hope...
I can help you.
...comes a visually spectacular emotional journey. Critics rave. It's an unforgettable masterpiece.
You will like a thrill.
...that will make your spirit soar.
For this is why you called me. Come on.
A Monster Calls.
Welcome back, chefs. Here you are. Each week, there will be two challenges.
Boom!
I want it.
That's you.
The winner survives, the loser leaves.
This is like straight up war.
The worst is yet to come.
Jeff, you're scaring me.
You have to beat three Iron Chefs.
You've got the consistency on the custard just right.
I like it. Thank you, Chef.
If you happen to succeed in this quest...
How much time?
You will be crowned as an Iron Chef.
Iron Chef Gauntlet, now streaming on SBS On Demand.
$1 riff, a minute to learn, a lifetime to master. Or is that Hungry Hungry Hippo? Anyway, listen carefully and identify the songs from which the following riffs have been ripped. Orchestra, activate the riffs. Buzz in, but Ian will probably not believe in himself and will never get it out.
I'll name the band, Mark can name the title. Please. The Angels.
Correct. And what's
6 months here, 6 months there sort of thing. But I've been home for a while. I'm loving it just a little bit too much.
Now, I'm just wondering, you've got Elton John walking into a record shop going, that looks quite good, have a listen. That girl, give her a call. Talk about it for 2 weeks, find a number. Does she have a manager? Let me do a bit of work. How weird is that?
Pretty weird, yeah.
But
I mean,
did you get the call from him personally?
Not the first time, no, it was kind of like a, you know, his people, my people sort of thing.
Yes, yes, I get that all the time, yes.
Yes, yes. But no, he got in contact with me to come see him play, actually. He wanted me to come and see him play in Sydney, so I went down and met him backstage, and he was just lovely, you know, he was a big fan. I was like, really?
That
Are
is
you sure?
And then you recorded a song together.
Yeah, we recorded a duet that was released in America on country radio. So
I'm sure we can Google that or iTunes it or something with the intraminette that I don't know how to use at all. Well, it's interesting because when Catherine came here tonight, because she's not often in the country of Australia visiting, we got her on the show. Of course, she brought family with her, as you would. They want to come and see her perform. And in our pre-selection, of course, before the show, her father was pretty keen to get up here and see if he could, well, cut the mustard. Steve, what relation are you to Catherine Britt?
I've never seen her before in my life. What? No, she's my daughter.
She is your daughter, ladies and gentlemen. I
can't believe that you're on the other team. I'm so going to lose.
Oh, you don't know who you've got next to you. I think you're fine. Oh, no, no, not that I'm talking you guys down at all, but it's my dad's a encyclopedia. Well, yep. Let's see if that actually works out tonight. Welcome, Catherine. Thank you. Very excited to have you on board. Now, no hints, Catherine, because you've been out the back with our other guests swapping fruity anecdotes about Dougal. So, who can it be, Maintenant? I formed my first band at the age of 15 to play in youth clubs around Christchurch, New Zealand. Now, look, you'd really be a bit embarrassed if you got it wrong.
Christchurch, New Zealand. I was at the ARIA Hall of Fame, and it's got to be Max Merritt. Christchurch, 15.
Please, make him very welcome. Max Merritt!
Hey, Western Union man, send a telegram to my baby. Send a telegram. Send it on to my baby. Gonna make it all right. Listen. Tell her that I'm all alone. Try to call her on the phone. Tell her I'm in misery. Think that she's a void of me. If a telegram won't do, send a box of candy too.